What is prayer? Prayer is not getting God prepared to do your will. Prayer is getting you prepared to do God's will. Prayer is the only way to release the supernatural power of God in your life, in your marriage, in your business, to show you great and mighty things that you know not. Prayer has the power to cure sickness and disease. Prayer can shatter the shackles of misery and habit that are tormenting your life, or the life of your son or daughter, or the life of your husband or wife. Prayer is the key that unlocks the gates of heaven and closes the gates of hell. Prayer does not need proof. Prayer needs practice. God is as close as your next prayer. Prayer is the weapon that God has given His children to wage war in the heavenlies. Church of Jesus Christ, stop whining about the attacks on your life by the prince of darkness and put on the whole armor of God in Ephesians 6. Attack and then attack again and then attack again and crush him and drive him out of your life, because Satan is a defeated foe. Christ has given you the keys of death, hell, and the grave. You are a child of God and the royal blood of heaven is flowing in your veins. You are destined to be more than a conqueror through Christ. Think like it, act like it, and talk like it every day of your life. If your marriage is under attack, pray. If your children are being tormented by the prince of darkness, pray. If your business is failing, pray. If you're fighting a deadly disease, pray. If you're lost and without God, pray. If your life is empty, if it's meaningless, if it seems to be hopeless, pray, 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 because God answers prayer. A prayerless Christian is a weak Christian. A prayerless Christian is a miserable Christian. A prayerless Christian is a Christian who always lives in defeat. A prayerless church is a weak church. A prayerless nation is a defeated nation. A prayerless family will be a divided family. It has been said and bears saying again, the family that prays together stays together. Husband, do you pray for your wife? Do you pray with your children? Why? Because according to 1 Samuel 12 and 23, you have sinned against the Lord if you don't. God expects you every day of the week to pray for the people in your house. Somebody prayed for you. Who are you praying for? What are you doing for the members of your family? What sense does it make to go around the world and win the lost and not win your own son and daughter? Why pray? Because God answers prayer. The Bible says, what you bind on earth, I'll bind in heaven. He has given you the authority to launch the initiative. Quit walking around in circles, wringing your hands saying, I wonder when God is going to do something. God in heaven is looking down at you and saying, I have given you the authority of my name. I have given you the power of my word. I have given you the sanctity of my blood. When are you going to use the power that I have given to you to blast the kingdom of hell and announce that Jesus Christ is Lord? The initiative rests with you. Why pray? Prayer will either make a man leave off sinning, or sin will make a man leave off praying. Don't tell God, I love you, but I'm not going to talk to you. God's not that silly. Why pray? Elijah, with one prayer, shut down the national economy. Now that's power. Who needs to talk to the President of the United States when you can talk to God Almighty? He has the power. An almighty, all-knowing, all-powerful God is sitting in heaven waiting to hear from you. Why pray? David says that he has his hand cupped behind his ear, listening for his children to ask him for great and mighty things that we know not. He's listening for us to pull down the strongholds of addictions that enslave our families, to pull down the strongholds of abortion and pornography. Let me tell you something. When you walk through these doors and you lift your hands to pray, I want you to remember that you are talking to Almighty, all-knowing, all-powerful God, the creator of heaven and earth. The blast of his nostrils can split the cedars of Lebanon. He holds the seven seas in the palms of his hand. He weighs the mountains in a scale and the hills in the balance. You can ask him for things so staggering, so big, that God slides out of his chair and sits on the edge and says to the angels, did you hear what he said? Ask him for things that are impossible, because with God nothing is impossible. Ask him to defeat the giants in your life, because our God is a giant killer. Ask him to divide the sea before you and to bury Pharaoh and watch him turn your enemies into fish food. Ask him. Ask him to send fire from heaven as he did for Elijah, and he will. Ask him to walk with you in the fire of the fiery furnace and be the fourth man in the fire, and he will. He said you will walk through the fire and the fire will not burn you. You will walk through the water and the water will not drown you. Ask him. He's the God who cannot fail. He's waiting to show you great and mighty things. Pray, pray, pray. God in heaven wants you to have that power. I'm asking for the Lord to make church a supernatural church, a supernatural church that can pray and believe that God can do the impossible. Jesus said, my house shall be called a house of prayer. If you want power with God, learn to pray. If you don't know how to pray, you will never be successful, because prayer can shape the destiny of your life. Pray.